Hi, I'm Sanjana Madhapa, and I work at the QPA Second Chance Adoption Center. I work with handling adoptions, with rehabilitation of dogs, with rescues. So basically, all around running of the center. QPA, it stands for Compassion Unlimited Plus Action. The organization has been was founded 27 years ago now by an English woman called Crystal Rogers. So she started the place out of literally a cow shed, and today we've expanded to seven centers across the city. And so this center, which is the Second Chance Adoption Center, is one of QPA's centers. This center was started in 2013, and we started it keeping in mind the fact that the number of dogs that were being given up and were being abandoned on the streets was increasing. And one of the biggest problems that shelters tend to face is that when you take in a healthy dog into a shelter, you have to keep in mind that you are also treating dogs over there with infections. You're treating dogs that might be carrying something life-threatening. So when you take a healthy dog into that environment, the chances of the dog picking that up is very, very high, which is what was happening. So a lot of healthy dogs were picking up infections and they were dying. Which was avoidable if there was a specific adoption center. So we kept that in mind when we started off. So Second Chance Adoption Center was started off in 2013, and we initially started off from a 4,900 square foot plot, which where we could house about 35 dogs. And that was the idea initially, but then last year we went up to 60 dogs in that space, and we realized it just wasn't working. We had to move to a larger space. The number of dogs being abandoned and given up was increasing year by year, which is something we hadn't taken into account. So we started construction last year, and we moved into this place this year in February.
Okay, so you're a mother as well of a 2-year-old. So what's more difficult, taking care of dogs or taking care of a baby?
I think working around dogs and having dogs kind of did also prepare me somewhere for having a kid. So I think they're both equally
challenging.
Yeah, they each have their own set of challenges.
So also a lot of people, they keep dogs away from the baby, thinking that it's infectious, they should not be there, like baby should be safe. So what's your take on that?
It's rubbish.
Yeah,
complete. So actually speaking, kids, there are so many studies that show that children who have grown up around dogs, who've grown up around animals in general, not just dogs, but who have grown up around animals, tend to have higher immunities than kids who have been kept isolated from them. And I think growing up around an animal is very important, because it teaches you compassion and empathy, which you don't learn otherwise. So I think it's very, very important.
Okay with 11, like 10 dogs.
Yeah, he kind of, that was the package deal when he married me. So yeah.
So what's the future of this organization? How far are you planning to take this?
Provided that we have the funding and we have the support, which we do today, which is, we have enormous support from the public, which is we really appreciate that. Provided we keep having this kind of support, we want to eventually get on par with the organizations that exist abroad.
Alright. Have you ever been bitten by a dog?
Yeah.
So I have. That didn't demotivate you or something?
No, it doesn't.
Was it bad?
Kind of. It was okay. It wasn't too bad. But it's okay. It's part and parcel of it. And you have to understand, the dogs don't bite without reason. They bite because they're either scared or because they've been pushed into a corner, where if they've had severe abuse in their past. So dogs aren't stupid, they're not just going to randomly bite for no reason.
So every mother has a favorite child, but they don't tell it.
Yeah.
So is it similar with your dogs at home?
I suppose. I mean, like, these, they all hold different places in my heart for different reasons. So it depends on when.
That's the answer of a mother.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's both.
Okay, so what's, according to you, the key to a happy marriage, since your husband agreed to you having 10 dogs at home? How does he, is he as dog-loving as you are?
No, he's not as dog-loving as I am. He loves animals, he loves the dogs we have at home, but he's not going to go and volunteer in a shelter. But I think what works for us is the fact that he doesn't expect me to change. and I don't expect him to change. So those expectations are not there. That it's unrealistic to expect that just because you've married someone, they're going to then change their entire lives for you. He knew who I was before we got married. I knew who he was before we got married. And we don't expect that to change. So it works.
There's been a recent case of a dog rape. It was a gang rape. So what's your take on that?
I think we really, our government really needs to wake up and realize that this is not just about animal welfare anymore. There is a reason why in the US, in the European countries, that they are putting crimes against animals in the same category as crimes against children, crimes against people, because it shows a bent of mind. It shows the way your mind works. Most serial killers, most psychopaths, most of your famous, like take Ted Bundy, take Manson, any of them, they all started off by killing animals. And then they progressed from killing animals to killing young children to killing adults. That's the progression that went, right? It is a psychological problem. If you can do that to an animal, you can do that to a human. There's no difference then. And our government really needs to wake up and see that this is a huge problem. It's not just about this one dog. It's not just about the tens of dogs that have been abused, beaten up, raped, whatever it is. It is a larger problem that they need to address.
But we already have Section 377, which says that sex with animal is a criminal offense.
Yes.
So, but like according to your answer, I feel that you are saying that government is not taking it seriously.
But what is the punishment for it? If your punishment is going to be, you're going to be jailed for 10 days and your fine is going to be 1,000 rupees, is it really going to deter anyone? You have to put it on par with, say, abuse to a child. Abuse of a human, you have to put it on par with that. Because this is leading up to that. These people, they get away with this now, they will then move on to a child. They will then move on to an adult.
So, why adoption? Why would you discourage people buying a dog and why would you encourage them to adopt?
Because our breeding laws in this country are completely abysmal. There are no breeding laws. Most of the people who go and buy puppies are buying pups that come from puppy mills and illegal breeders, where they're using the dogs heat cycle after heat cycle. They're producing puppies. They don't know where the pups have gone. They don't produce healthy puppies. They're selling unhealthy pups to people who don't know any better. They're making it very cheap to kill the market. So people don't go to the actual so-called legitimate breeders. Most people won't go to them because their puppies will cost you 45,000, 50,000, up to 1 lakh, 2 lakhs. That's how much you're paying for a legitimate breeder's pup. Whereas if someone's making it available to you at 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 rupees, you're getting a Saint Bernard pup for 8,000. Why wouldn't you want to buy it? But then they don't see that the pups are going to have health issues. They're going to have behavioral issues. So until our laws in our country become stronger, until the breeding laws become stronger, and until this wave of abandoning dogs and animal cruelty doesn't end, don't buy. Don't support puppy mills. Come to a shelter, take a dog from a shelter, because you're not just saving that dog's life, you are freeing up a place in the shelter so that another dog can be taken in.
Also, there are a lot of cases of dog stealing and all. So do you get cases like that, that they ask you that you lost a dog or...
Yeah.
Are you,
yeah, we do. But a majority of the time, the dogs that are being stolen for breeding. They're being stolen for puppy mills.
So there's a black market of dog things going on.
Very much.
So there's nothing, like no investigation about
the police don't take it seriously. There are very few of them that take it seriously.
But is it also because there are less complaints?
No, there are... We get a complaint on almost an everyday basis, which we take to the cops. The cops don't take us seriously. For them, it's, you know, we have so many other things to deal with. Why would we want to deal with this?
Yeah.
What's the importance? It's just a dog. For them, it's just a dog. It's not a dog from the person that they've stolen from. So, yeah.
So, any message to the people from your organization to them?
Support the organizations that are doing the work in the city. You don't have to support only in terms of finances. Support in terms of raising awareness. Support in terms of putting the word out into your corporates. Support in terms of coming and volunteering. These dogs, they love having company. So even if you don't want to donate money, come just spend time with them. You can help us clean the center. You can help us feed them, bathe them. And of course, always adopt, choose to adopt. You're doing a very good thing. And these dogs have a lot of love to give. It's just that they need someone to give them a chance. So, yeah.